What if Google Documents, Notion, and Obsidian had a baby and had an AI brain to it too? Well, today we're going to review a software called Kortex, Kortex with a K. And the application is an AI-powered second brain that wants to help you bring all of your ideas together. It is not just a regular application. It's created by another YouTuber called Dan Co, and he has millions of subscribers. So today we're going to see whether this application is worth your time and attention. Today's video is kindly brought to you by Sensama. A little bit more about them later on, but you can find them linked below. So this one is an interesting one. It wants to be very much AI focused, and it is a clean looking, easy to use note-taking application. We're gonna explore firstly the features, pricing, and availability. So this one is available through web, and it has a Windows and Mac version. It doesn't have a mobile version either on iOS or Android. The application is priced for free. You can take unlimited notes and stuff like that, but you are limited with the AI features at a $10 per month pricing with increased pricing for more features. So if you want to go full AI on this, then you're going to have to pay for it, but the basic elements of it are free to use. And of course, that's good news for you. So this application slightly stands out from the others because it's very heavily AI focused. The application can do a range of different things, like change the LLM that you use as you're communicating with your notes. It'll also have a feature called a library, which helps you to extract highlights and bring together insights from your Readwise account. So it's got loads of features packed inside this application that are very AI-centric and designed to help you communicate with your notes more effectively. So I think the best place to start is to jump in and show you some of the features. So the first feature you can have is the capture feature. This is great for attaching any important notes or important tasks to each of the notes or documents that you've created in your account. This is really helpful on the side to quickly capture them and mention the relevant document. You can also chat with each of your notes inside of the account, and you can choose to use artificial intelligence as part of this. And what's different about Kortex is you can swap what language model you use. This is limited in the free plan, but you can unlock pretty much all of the major LLM models as part of the premium. Now, as part of this AI chat feature, there are some abilities that you do typically see inside these applications. Like if you're looking to take some notes on a YouTube video that you're trying to extract information and insight from, then you can actually do that just by pasting the URL of the YouTube video. You can actually extract some of the key insights and prompt it with questions, which is incredibly valuable. There are also AI workflows, which means you can create a master prompt and use it more routinely to help narrow down your searches. Now, the documents work really well. You can use Markdown here, and the clean look makes each of the documents really nice. You can go into something called focus mode, which I found a really good feature. And any time you can open up this chat alongside it or multiple windows at the same time. What I quite like most about the documents is that you can create these little things called elements, which allow you to create, I guess, templates for the future, which you can reuse across all of your documents. This is perfect for crafting something that is more unique each time in terms of its note and its structure, which is really valuable. So other things I did notice as well is you can export all of this to Markdown so that you're not locked into Kortex if you decide to move applications, which is very beneficial for a lot of people. And the library is a great place to bring in sources, and you can start chats that you can see in the left-hand panel at any given time. So today's video is sponsored by Sensama. Sensama is a powerful, mindful task management software, and it's really popular for those who want to stand back and plan their day more effectively. There's guided planning, reflection upon each of the days that you complete, and great systems in place to help you focus, but also make sure you're not stuffing your calendar and task management with lots and lots of tasks. So check out Sensama below, and thanks for those guys for sponsoring today's video. So in terms of the pros of this application, I really liked how it put together everything in one. The speed and function were very fast inside of this application, no issues, and I liked how you can build these elemental templates, but there are some limitations to how many custom templates you can add or components as part of the free pricing. I'll include details there because it's obviously subject to change. I also like how well it's designed for the writing element of it. If you're looking to use this to really use AI to refine stuff, there is a really good video on the channel that helps you break down how they wrote, I think, 30 tweets from basically prompting it and narrowing down your options. options, which is one of the benefits of the AI workflow. I like the focus modes and the design of the application is really, really good. So moving on to some of the cons of this experience. To be honest, there's no offline mode just yet, which is a little bit of a pain. You have to be online to use this application. And combine that with the lack of mobile applications on both iOS and Android, it does feel like being able to use this application on the go, well, it's not possible unless you're using the web version, which is obviously very much reliant on Wi-Fi or internet. And the free plan actually had some pretty good pricing, but it did lack the AI features. I believe you get 10 uses of the KAI feature, which is part of this. But that's fairly reasonable and probably very common for most applications. So one of the other cons that I noticed is that the capture mode, for me at least, was a little bit confusing. You capture stuff, but you can only associate each of the notes, so they almost act as little notes for your notes, in a sense, and almost like comments versus actually practically using them within a note, if that makes sense. If there was something like resolve comments, that would be even more helpful, but I feel like the capture abilities, whilst useful because I send myself notes all the time, whether that's through email or through Todoist, but this could be a lot better, I think. So who is this application best for? To be honest, probably best for those who are creators, writers, and thinkers that are using the second brain concept. This application does a really good job. I feel like it's a good blend between capacities and also popular apps like Tana and Obsidian. It doesn't have some of the power features that I typically see with these type of applications, but the general well-designed structure and unique elements of the components do make this application really good. So that was my overview of Kortex. If you're somebody that's a desktop user who likes AI, this is going to be a good app for you and has the capacity to be able to set up a system like this. I think this is a good application for that. But the application is an interesting one and is obviously still continually progressing. So thanks so much for stopping by. Thank you very much to Sansama for sponsoring. You can check them out below and I will see you in a future video, I'm sure. Cheerio for now.